What is good, mga ka-champion, and welcome back to another video. For today's video, guys, I will share with you a potential buy or long opportunity for Europound. Okay, so another paldo-paldo setup na naman tayo, guys. But then again, we will only execute once it satisfies our system rules based on logical reasoning. Okay, so again, I will check our market structure, price action, and other confluences that would correlate dun sa ating TFPOR system. Okay. So if you want to become a student and be part of our TFP VIP Champions growing community, go check out our 90-day mentorship program. Okay? So again, thank you so much to all my TFP VIP Champions students all over the globe, subscribers, followers, and sa lahat po ng mga sumusuporta. Right? So without further ado, wala na po tong pick-tong-pick pa. Let's go straight to our charts. Alright, so again, we are currently here sa Europound and this is a live chart, alright? Alright, so makikita natin, no? I am on higher time frame. First things first, we must check every time our chart on a bigger picture. So that's why, as a good practice, mas magandang simulan natin on a higher time frame. So currently, kung makikita nyo, this is a live chart on a daily time frame. And first thing that I saw is, simply, market is downtrend. But nevertheless, sabi ko nga, don't be fooled by the trend itself, okay? You must check the overall market structure including yung past historical data para makita nyo if it coincides with your specific level of support or resistance that would allow you to have the opportunity whether to buy or sell. But take note, hindi enough lang yung mga trend or key leveling nyo. Dapat meron silang confluence sa isa't isa para maging logical yung inyong entry and execution. Okay? So, let us check. So, apparently, kita naman natin, di ba? So, meron tayong consolidation phase dito and nagkaroon ng downtrend. But nevertheless, you always have to ask, nasan ba yung current market? Okay? Don't be fooled, sabi nga, by the trend itself. So, check nyo sa kaliwa, historical data, saan nagsasettle ngayon yung current price. Yun yung isang way para mas magbigay sa inyo ng high probability of a winning trade. Okay? So ngayon, if I would to check tong market structure from the left side, okay? So evident that there is still a significant structure from the left. So in that sense, pwede kayo makakuha ng idea that whether this is going to a buy setup or a sell setup. So sabi ko nga from my video from this opening, di ba, that we can have a potential buy opportunity. So let us see if it satisfies our system rules and if we can execute a specific trade. Okay, so ngayon, if I were to put a horizontal line, okay, so it's quite obvious that the market reacted to historical data from the past. Okay, so extend ko lang tong. So again, guys, I'm just using a simple line here, but take note, normally yung key level ng support and resistance is in range. But again, if you want to check out yung how to really properly use and how to read yung ating support and resistance, meron akong video that I've shared few weeks ago. Okay, so I'll just post yung link dito sa video na to. So makita natin, merong multiple reactions from the past. So ibig sabihin niyan, this is a significant level ngayon na kung saan nagre-react yung yung market. Okay, on a higher time frame. So ibig sabihin, long-term perspective, nasa key level of support tayo, which means there are area of buyers. But do take note, hindi porket nasa support ka is magbabay ka na all of a sudden. Take note, hindi enough yung key leveling lang as a means para mag-execute. You have to satisfy certain conditions whether you're going to have a long position or not. Okay? So, kaya nga sinasabi ko, this is only a potential long. Okay? So, ngayon, ano nakita natin? From this level of support, okay, makikita natin that the market is kind of, nagsisettle siya ngayon dito sa, tandaan nyo guys, kapag kayo ay bibili, okay, you have to make sure, you have to overcome, overpower yung mga sellers from that specific time frame. And in that sense, kung makita nyo, meron ako ditong bearish candle. Okay? Which, apparently, which yung ginagawa nating practice, di ba? You always have to check your previous daily high and low. So, ibig sabihin yan, yung daily, previous daily candle high mo ay ito, di ba? Okay. So, obvious naman. Dahil yung current candle ngayon is ongoing pa. Okay? Which means, ano babasin mo? Yung ating previous daily high at yung ating bearish candle, okay, they are somewhat settling on a common point. Ibig sabihin, hindi pa na-overpower ngayon ng buyers yung mga sellers. So, bakit? Intact pa tong daily high nung ano? Recent, ano natin, bearish candle. So, ibig sabihin, the momentum of sellers are still here. Okay? So, ibig sabihin niyan, hindi pa tayo pwedeng mag-buy right away. Okay? What we're analyzing right now is, do we have any confluence na magsasabi na pwede na akong bumili? As of this point, on a daily time frame, wala pa. Okay? So, that is why, maybe we can have an opportunity on a much lower time frame. Yun yung kailangan nating check para mas magkaroon tayo ng better structure as an analysis. In support dito nga dun sa analysis natin. Okay? So, ngayon, alam na natin that these are the boundaries and nagre-react ngayon yung ating market or yung previous daily high natin or previous candle dito saan? Ito yung previous candle natin dito sa bearish candle on the past few days. Okay, so bababa ko ng 4 hours to verify whether is there any significant structure na pwede kong gamitin as a confluence to support my long position analysis. Okay? So ngayon, okay, kung makita natin, they are settling on a common point which is yung resistance nga. So ibig sabihin yan, the only time that I will buy is kapag ka nag-push through yung market dito sa boundary na yan. So meron tayong common point of resistance range dito. Diba kung makita nyo, yung ating bearish candle high, okay, at yung ating daily candle, previous daily candle high ay itong point na yan. So, ibig sabihin, ito yung range kung saan we can call that as a major resistance at sa time frame na to. Okay? So, resistance level yan. So, ibig sabihin yan, there are a bunch of sellers as of this point. Eh, sabi nga natin, we want to buy, but take note, is there any confluence na satisfy na natin? May isa lang ako nakikita, which is ito, significant. Diba? So, ano mapapansin nyo? Okay? Although nasa resistance tayo, ito pa yung hurdle natin na kailangan nating malagpasan, okay, as a buyer. So, do take note, I will only buy if this satisfies yung ating system rules 40 FPOR system. And sabi nga natin, if you are going to buy on a TFPOR system long position, kailangan you are above horizontal horizontal support, trend line support, at broken counter trend line resistance. So, ibig sabihin, yung iyong buy setup would be around this area. So, dapat, logically, meron kang ganyang setup. Okay? So, at least two, di ba? So, ayun yung ideal setup natin but as a benchmark. But take note, kung dalawa lang, okay na yun as a confluence. So, as of now, ang nasa-satisfy ko pa lang ay itong di ba? Itong counter trend line resistance break, which yun nga yung in-exhibit ng market coming from this high, okay, low, lower high, lower low, okay, lower high, lower low, okay. I am reading now as a market structure. So, ibig sabihin yan, yung group of trend ko pagdating sa bearish ay around this area. So, tinuturo ko rin to, di ba, that or every time that you are confused pagdating sa market structure, try to break it down or try to group it into their own market structure, okay, or trend cycle, okay? So, ibig sabihin, ito yung bearish cycle, but nevertheless, nasa gray area pa tayo eh. Bakit gray area? Okay, although may break na tayo ng counter trend line resistance, ito, nagsasettle pa yung price dito sa friction na to ng resistance level, okay? So, as a buy, it is not wise to buy yet dahil nga nasa gray area pa tayo ng ating market. Which means, hindi pa wise na bumili. So, mangyayari lang yan if market potentially, tandaan nyo, saan yung potential bounce ng market as a long position. Okay, yan na yung mamap out natin. Okay? So, interpret natin to, take note, ang gusto kong mangyari is, magkaroon tayo ng logical trendline support at above nitong ano, above nitong friction natin, which is around this area, di ba? So, this would be our buy area. But do take note, potentially, market can have a deeper correction. Okay? So, ano mangyari yung deeper correction? Makikita nyo dito, coming from this view, di ba? Dun sa pinakailalim, meron tayong 4-hour bearish candle. So, ibig sabihin, significant to as a potential bounce that would satisfy yung ating ano, yung ating rules. Okay? So, tandaan nyo, hindi pa nangyayari yung correction. Hindi pa nangyayari, wala pa akong point na pwedeng i-connect dito sa ano, sa trendline support. So, ibig sabihin yan, it is not wise na bumili pa. So, we're just mapping out yung mga potential moves na pwedeng kapag nagkaroon tayo ng correction, okay, mag-bounce dito, okay, so pwede ko nang i-connect yan, and pag nabasag tong trend resistance, yan yung gusto natin. This would be our buy HPT as a setup. Okay, diba? So, kaya sinasabi ko na potential buy setup to dahil nga nag-exhibit na yung mga clues one by one. So, una pa lang yung counter trend resistance, and I would have to wait and be patient na mag-materialize tong setup. And potentially, tandaan nyo rin, pwede rin tong area na to once mag-bounce dito yung ano, market. Tandaan nyo, variable pa tong trend support kasi hindi pa nangyayari yung correction or yung ano, pullback, di ba? So, again, anything can happen sa market, but I'm giving you ideas that this is one way how you should trade to map out all the potential move ng market based on your rules, okay? Kung magkaiba tayo ng system or iba tayo ng system rules, then it will be a different scenario, okay? It may have an alignment with my system, basic system, tandaan nyo guys. But then again, what I'm showing you here is an idea on how you should trade as a long setup, okay? So, I'm not saying this is a perfect setup, but then again, alam ko yung gusto kong mangyari, okay? Kailangan lang mag-align yung aking condition ng market dun sa system rules. Yun lang naman eh. As a trader, we have to align or we have to satisfy our rules dun sa condition ng market. Otherwise, we don't have any trade and we just have to observe dun sa market. Okay? So again, we'll just see how it goes, no? Ang importante dito is makita natin ano yung mga pwede natin i-trade. Okay? So, abantayan natin to and I will share with you ano yung mangyayari later on. But take note, this is a long potential setup. Not unless mabasag to. Sabi ko nga, I don't have any trade yet. Okay, so I may have short-term opportunities like scalping along the way, but to take note, as a swing trader, no, it is best na maghintay kasi bakit? Swing trader provides more better gains, okay, on a less risk. Okay, so yes, so that will be it for today. I hope nag-provide na naman to ng value on some ideas on how you can look for opportunities regardless kung anumang condition ng market. Importante is you have a system that have confluence and logical reasoning whether you are going to buy or sell, right? So again, thank you so much to all my TFP, VIP, champion, students all over the globe, subscribers, followers, and sa lahat po ng mga sumusuporta, right? So see you all on the next videos. God bless and bye-bye.
Oh, I just want to inform and announce that our TFP VIP Champion Student private Discord community is already up. And yeah, here we have several channels wherein we share our technical trading ideas among each other. And of course, we also have our weekly trade ideas para sa ating mga weekly forecast para sa mga currency pairs. And some announcement section. And of course, since tayo ay global, of course, we have other students as well na galing sa mga ibang bansa overseas. So, we here introduce ourselves and introduce kung saan tayo galing, sa bansa tayo ngayon, OFW man o hindi. But nevertheless, this is a healthy community para mag-share ng mga trading ideas para sa inyo guys. And hopefully, I will be putting up a server publicly para sa mga baguhan naman and those mga followers and subscribers natin. Alright? So yeah, this is just a minor announcement, and hopefully guys, you can join us and make this community grow, lalo na sa ating mga estudyante nag-aaral. Alright guys, so mga baguhan pa lang, but nevertheless, everyone here wants to learn, wants to make profit from the market, but as much as possible, we're all equal in the eyes of the market. Alright guys, so that would be it. So yun lang, and thank you very much. Alright, bye-bye.